company we own in the portfolio is Oerlikon, and we've owned that in our global portfolios for a few years now. Oerlikon is based in Switzerland, but it really is a global business. And they have three main businesses in which they're global leading companies: a surface treatment business, a man-made fiber business, and a drives business. At the time we were buying it, the man-made fiber business was in a cyclical downturn. Other investors and analysts were rating Oerlikon down because of that business. We took a longer view of the business and really thought the value of Oerlikon would be substantially higher looking out 5 years or longer. And so we started buying the stock around 12. That fiber business continued to be weak and the stock went down to 9. And we bought a whole lot more. We took the weighting up significantly in our portfolios. And since then, the businesses have turned around. The surface treatment business is doing very well. The fiber business has hit bottom and has turned up. And the drives business has improved greatly as well. And so the stock is currently about 17. And the optionality, the extra feature of Oerlikon is the investment they're making in additive manufacturing. That's currently a cost to the business, which is understating earnings. But looking out 5 years or more, we think that can be a substantial contributor to the company. Another company which we recently bought for the portfolio is Henry Schein. It's a U.S.-based business that's primarily involved in distribution of consumable items and equipment to medical practices. What created the opportunity for us was the idea that the market was marking down Henry Schein stock based on the view that Amazon was going to come in that business and take share and take margins down significantly in the business. But if you understand the business, it's the type of business that's very high touch. Henry Schein has all sorts of sales reps and specialty people visiting the doctors, visiting the dentists, and they're able to provide value to the practice more so than just the simple distribution of consumable items. So Henry Schein is a high value added proposition to the customer, and it's a type of business that's going to be very difficult for Amazon to disrupt. Usually the number one or number two company in their fields, they tend to be gaining market share, and they tend to be winning against their competitors, but the opportunity comes when other investors take a view of a company that we think is simply wrong. And a lot of times that view is simply based on difference in time frame.